lateral earth pressures. These are all about the geotechnical applications. First, at rest, the earth pressure at rest, active earth pressure, and passive earth pressure. And the theories are given by Rankine's earth pressure theory. In geotechnical engineering, it is often necessary to prevent lateral soil movements. That is, we need to give some lateral support. Earth pressure at rest. In homogeneous natural soil deposit, a soil element, if you take it, and sigma V dash, that is effective stress, vertical effective stress, and horizontal sigma H is horizontal effective stress on the soil element. The ratio of sigma H dash by sigma V dash is a constant known as coefficient of earth pressure at rest. Importantly, K0 state, there is no lateral strains, means there is no movement of the element. For normally consolidated clays and granular soils, K0 is equal to 1 minus sun phi dashed, that is effective intergranular friction. For over consolidated clays, K0 is equal to K0 normally consolidated and OCR, over consolidation ratio, to the power of or root of OCR. We can see that. For elastic analysis, K0 is equal to nu by 1 minus nu, that is nu is a Poisson's ratio of the soil. Active and passive earth pressures in granular soils, means only sandy type of soils. Wall moves away from the soil or wall moves towards the soil. Wall moves towards the soil is passive earth pressure, or wall moves away from the soil is active earth pressure. Quantifying the active earth pressure in granular soils. Sigma V dash is equal to gamma into Z. And initially there is no lateral movement. Sigma H is equal to K0 into sigma V. So that is equal to K0 into gamma Z. As the wall moves away from the soil and sigma V remains the same because of the depth, and sigma H decreases because the wall is not supporting the soil until the failure occurs, that is active state. In the active state, as the wall moves away from the soil, initially K0 state and failure of active state, then the sigma V is constant and sigma E is reduces, means going towards the shear line. And if the failure envelope is drawn, it touches the failure envelope. Once if it touches the failure envelope, the active earth pressure is at and the failure takes place. So active earth pressure, sigma H dash is equal to active, is equal to Ka into sigma V dash. That is, Ka is equal to 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi. That is equal to tan square 45 minus phi by 2 is given, is Rankine's coefficient of active earth pressure. Active earth pressure for cohesive soils. Sigma H dashed is equal to active is equal to Ka into sigma V dash minus 2C into root of Ka. Wherever the C is 0, then it satisfies the granular soils. Passive earth pressure in granular soils. Initially, soil is in K0 state. as the wall moves towards the soil, sigma v dash remains the same and sigma h increases till failure occurs. Passive earth pressure granular soils as the wall moves towards the soil, that is a more circle stress, that stress increases, it's then it touches the failure envelope. So this is known as, initially it is a K0 state and it is a KP, it becomes KP. Passive earth pressure is sigma h dash passive is equal to KP into sigma v dash. This KP is given by 1 plus sin phi by 1 minus sin phi, that is tan square 45 plus phi by 2. This is Rankine's coefficient of passive earth pressure. Passive earth pressure in cohesive soils, that is sigma h dash passive is equal to Kp into sigma v dash plus 2c root of Kp. If c is 0, everything else is the same for the granular soils. Earth pressure distribution. The earth pressure at top of the wall is 0. And bottom of the wall is maximum, that is Ka into gamma h in one side, which is h is the height of the wall, and another side it is small h, it is shown. If the wall moves away from the fill, then the bottom of the wall moves into the fill, so it is passive earth pressure, and top is active earth pressure, but the earth pressure is measured, and Pa is the total earth pressure if it is given. So 0 on the top and bottom, this gives a triangular variation of the earth pressure, and it acts 1/3 above the base, and it is the area of the triangle and 1 meter perpendicular to the slide, the is taken into consideration. So that is what earth pressure distribution. A graph is drawn again, wall movement. So sigma h is the zero K0 state, it is shown in the this one. And the wall movement is, and this side the passive state is there, which is more than K0 state, and the active state, this the sigma is very less than passive state, so K0 is in between that. Earth pressure, type of wall movement, type and amount of wall movement, shear strength parameters of the soil, unit weight of the soil, drainage condition in the backfill is there. So at rest, active pressure, passive pressure, all the three are there. These are the variables which we consider in earth pressure. Rankine's theory of earth pressure is equal to, it is given, sigma h dashed active is equal to Ka into sigma v dashed minus 2c root of Ka, and sigma h dashed in passive Kp sigma v dashed plus 2c into root of Kp. In this, a smooth wall is assumed, means there is no friction between soil and the wall, and applicable only vertical walls. It is applicable, the above equations and all are applicable only on the vertical walls and their movements.